Scapa Flow 1919, Scapa Flow 1939. Two dates inscribed in red in the annals of war at sea. Two dates spanning 20 years. Two dramas that have had momentous historical consequences. Scapa Flow is an immense natural harbor formed by the Orkney Islands, which are separated from the northern coast of Scotland by a narrow passage. At these latitudes, the storms from the Atlantic and the North Sea are terrible, but they never reach Scapa Flow. Over the ages, this safe haven has always served as a shelter for the great navigators. The Vikings dropped anchor here in the 10th century, perhaps drawn by the barren and sinister landscape. These violent Nordic conquerors raised numerous religious monuments to invoke the protection of their gods. The Royal Navy has always made use of this harbor, where she can moor the largest vessels discreetly and securely. In fact, the entire fleet could anchor in Scapa Flow, whose only access is through two deep water passages, which are easily surveyed and defended. From the beginning of the First World War, the English had made this their principal naval base. Here, to take on supplies and coal, came the squadrons of capital ships, so that they could enforce a total maritime blockade on Germany. Rather than engage her great fleet, the second largest in the world, Germany, with the aid of her advanced technology, developed and perfected the submarine. War at sea was about to change. For certain German officers who had become aces at submarine warfare, the ambition to penetrate the fortified base at Scapa Flow had become an obsession. On the 23rd of November 1914, Captain von Henning, commanding the U-18, attempted to force the passage submerged, but he couldn't overcome the powerful tidal current and was forced to surface. Immediately he was shelled by the coastal batteries. Escape was impossible. At 3:10 p.m., the sub was scuttled and the crew surrendered. Fearing a new submerged German offensive, the Admiralty locked Scapa Flow. In all of the passages between the islands, old cargo ships and barges were sunk.